These are the new Nothing phones, 3A and 3A Pro. They have the usual Nothing design language, with transparent back, visible screws, and the glyph lights. But this time, something is different. These ribbon cables are fake. In phone 1 and phone 2, there was a functional charging coil with these functional ribbon cables. But in the phone 3A, this whole section is just decorative. A new company like Nothing that gained the trust of millions of consumers with its transparent design might be drifting away from it. And there's nothing new in it. Apple did the same thing with the Mac. They got the initial attention and success with the transparent iMac G3, but then they slowly moved away from it. Similarly, Braun became famous with the iconic DG60 with the transparent lid and the visible spinning wheel. But eventually, they also moved to opaque designs. But why? Why do no companies stick to transparent design style forever? Why is it so challenging to show what's actually inside the product? And is Nothing gonna follow the same trend and eventually will just give us a glass back in the name of transparent design? To answer all this question, first, we have to understand the basics of how trust works. People trust what they can see. It's almost instinctive. Like if you walk into a bakery or a pastry shop, you see rows of bread and cakes behind a clear glass display. And right away, you feel comfortable. There's no guesswork and no hidden surprises. You know exactly what you're getting. Same pattern happens in the subway. You watch them build your sandwich step by step. It feels fresh because it's all out in the open. Even McDonald's does this to an extent. The cooks are right there in your view. So when you're paying or waiting for your order, you can see them flipping burgers. And that level of openness reassures you, even though all of us have seen the time lapse of the bun. Transparent packaging works the same way. Fruits, veggies, grains, all comes in the see-through plastic cover. And if for some reason it's not transparent, then they put pictures on the wrapper. It instantly takes away all your doubts. Or take medicine blister packs. If we have two identical pills, one in a silver opaque packaging and the other one in a clear package, people usually pick the clear one, even though they have no clue about the chemistry of the pill. But just seeing it feels honest and safe. And eventually, this trust found its way into product design, starting with Braun DG60. Detail lamps decided to show the internal components instead of hiding them. The transparent lid was an intentional decision to showcase the precision of the mechanics inside. Users could see the spinning tape passing through the central mechanisms over the black field. All these visuals gave the users a feeling that they truly understand how it worked. Swatch took this to fashion with the Swatch Jellyfish, a simple design but fully transparent. People loved seeing the inner workings of the watch. It made the technology feel more advanced, even though it was just a regular quartz movement. Then there's Dyson. They didn't just make vacuum cleaners more powerful, they made them transparent. Watching the dust and dirt getting sucked up turned cleaning into an advanced experience. You could actually see it working, which made it even more effective. And then, Apple took transparency mainstream with the iMac G3. Before this, computers were dull beige boxes that felt more like industrial equipment than personal devices. And the iMac changed that. It was colorful, inviting, and for the first time, it made technology feel approachable. The translucent shell made it feel futuristic and friendly at the same time. You can check out the whole design analysis of iMac here in this video about Johnny Ive. And now, Nothing has taken this idea even further, turning transparency into their entire brand identity. Unlike the iMac, this is not just about making tech look friendly. It's about making it look raw and engineered. The visible screws, the glowing glyph interface, the wireless charging coil, the ribbon cables, and the overall transparent aesthetic with the plastic cover was a bold design move, but also a challenge to pull off. Because designing a transparent product is much harder than it looks. It's not just about making the body see-through, it changes the entire way a product has to be designed, engineered, and manufactured. And the first challenge that comes up is material selection. Transparent materials, whether plastic or glass, behaves very differently from standard opaque ones. Plastic, for example, is easier to mold, but it scratches very easily and can yellow over time due to UV exposure. Glass, on the other hand, is more premium, but it's fragile and adds weight and cost to the product. And if a clear product loses clarity, it loses its entire appeal. I mean, they can apply special coatings to reduce scratches, resist fingerprints, and prevent discoloration, but that adds another level of complexity in manufacturing. Then, the next challenge that comes up is selection of internal components and sourcing them. In a standard product, you can use any components that you want. It doesn't matter what shape they are, what color they are shiny or textured, because wires, screws, and sensors, all of them can just be hidden under the shell. But in a transparent product, everything is exposed. Every circuit board, ribbon cable, and battery has to be visually clean and well arranged. That means standard off-the-shelf components might not work. Instead, you have to source custom design parts that not only function well, but also matches the design language of your product. Sometimes you find it easily, and sometimes you have to pay extra for that luxury. And just sourcing all of the components is not good enough. Then you have to design all the internal architecture of that product. Even small details like the screw placement and PCB layout become an important design decision. For example, take the Nothing phone again. The screws are deliberately placed in a visually balanced layout. The wireless charging coil is designed to be a focal point, and the internal flex cables are neatly routed. And if this internal architecture is not considered early in the design phase, the final product can look unfinished and messy. That's why making a transparent product takes much longer development cycles and higher cost, because you're essentially designing the inside of a product like its outside. And I think this is the reason Nothing is drifting away from it. If you see Nothing's timeline, they launched the Ear One in 2021. It was the pilot product, so they got ample time to select and source each component carefully. Then the first phone was launched in 2022. Again, it was the first phone, so they had all the time to select the right ribbon cables and charging coils. Then the phone 2 was launched in 2023, in which they even improved the visual harmony of the phone. But overall, the design was similar to the phone 1. Then the phone 2A was launched in 2024 with a new design, which means they only got 1 year of development time. And of course, they want to bring some new designs in their product. But maybe for a transparent design style, it's difficult to find and source new components that fits your new design in just 1 year. And that's why in the phone 2A, they used a decorative ribbon cable instead of a visible and functional cable like the earlier models. This is just my speculation. Of course, I don't know what goes behind the closed doors at Nothing. Unlike the transparent components in the phone 1, you can't see what's going on there. But for now, in Nothing devices, transparency just means the visible screws with some light shows. But I genuinely think that even if companies like Nothing decide not to fully showcase their internals, those internals should still look visually appealing. Take Apple for example. Macs are not transparent anymore. But if you open up, you see beautifully arranged components. So even if Apple replaced the aluminium with a glass body tomorrow, the devices would still look incredibly good from inside. And it's very important, because someday your product will encounter an issue. At that point, someone, maybe even the user, will open it up. And even if it's broken, a thoughtfully designed interior will give the user a lot of trust, and they will buy the same product again. Because the real reason a consumer comes back to the same product is trust, not marketing, not ads. Transparent design like Nothing's can help you build the trust initially, but maintaining it depends on consistent quality and careful internal design, even if that means that you will not launch a new product every single year. That's all for today. I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.